The University of North Carolina at Pembroke's nursing department is enjoying a near $30 million dream come true.
Our vision became a reality, and we've been planning this vision for 6 years.
When you were checking his pulse, did you get something similar?
I did on the pediatric. It was pretty
close?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Okay. Each day we get up excited about coming to work and realizing that the vision that we had 6 years ago actually is here today.
I just want to do a quick assessment and check out all your vital signs and see how you're doing today.
Anthony Neal is a UNCP nursing student who's on active duty in the U.S. Army. Earning his degree will make Anthony an officer in the U.S. Army Nursing Corps.
Just want to listen to your vital signs here.
There's not too much of a difference. Healthcare is healthcare. The nuances are subtle. In the military hospitals, such as Womack, which is on Fort Bragg here, it's more military-oriented.
James Nicholson was 15 years into his previous career when the recession changed all his plans. His wife is a nurse. She's never lost a job, and she convinced him that nursing jobs are stable. But James had to get over a few hang-ups about being a nurse.
Would you mind getting his blood pressure for me?
Certainly. It just didn't seem like the manly thing. And when I got into it, I found it has no stigma. There is no such thing as a stigma attached to caring. You know, regardless of whether you're male or female, we all feel the same type of compassion and empathy for people.
Anthony and James are but two stories from UNC Pembroke's nursing program. Over 100 of their nursing student colleagues are now using state-of-the-art equipment to train in near real-world situations. Healthcare can be administered in the lab with no harm to real-life human patients.
I can make him sweat, he can cry, he can have a seizure, he can cough, he can moan, he can vomit.
UNC Pembroke nursing professor Martha Hepler teaches clinical labs from behind smoked glass. She works one-on-one with her students using a state-of-the-art computer program mannequin.
It's so wonderful for the students because we get to come in and practice on the mannequins and not be afraid to hurt them or make them cry.
The team calls this mannequin Bobby. He's a human simulator capable of cyber suffering a whole host of symptoms.
I click a button and he will start sweating.
And on the camera, you're watching your students.
I am watching my students, and you see she is wiping his forehead because he is sweating. Because I clicked it here and now there's water coming out of his forehead, like a patient that's sweating in the hospital.
Do you want me to get you some ice?
Jennie Zary is capping 4 military tours of duty by earning her bachelor's degree in nursing.
You have to put the pieces together and to create what is going on with the patient.
Way back when, the instructor literally had to be hanging over the student's shoulders, and it made them nervous. And the cameras might make them nervous too, but at least here we can kind of step out of the room. We can watch through the window, and we can also watch through this at the same time we're recording it so that we're able to play that back for the students.
Having them hang over my shoulder, that makes me actually a lot more nervous than knowing that she's manipulating the sim man. I can actually kind of focus on my virtual patient or my sim man and treat him or her like it was my client in the clinical setting.
120 over 80, it's excellent.
Taking us out of the picture, I think they'll be able to think more clearly and look at the client and feel more like it's a one-on-one patient interaction.
The Institute of Medicine has reported that America needs 80% of its nursing workforce to earn or hold 4-year degrees.
Are you a little bit hot?
When we look at our literature and we think about how we are going to be able to effectively graduate nurses that are successful and that we see better patient outcomes, I think nursing schools are moving in this direction.
And his heart rate's at 104.
UNC Pembroke is set to increase its nursing department enrollment, which should fill its newly found capacity with long-range plans to offer advanced nursing degrees.